Hello. In this video, we'll talk about how you can integrate your Maven Cucumber Test Automation Framework with Jira for uploading test results and downloading features from Jira in your Test Automation Framework. So the general workflow is that your features are stored in the plugin in Jira, and we've already covered that in the previous videos, which links to those are available in this video description. We'll focus now on the Maven and Test Automation side of things today. So first, we'll set up a feature. And this is a simple feature file which searching for search data on Google and has one scenario which does the same, and with some basic steps by navigating to the Google homepage, in entering some search criteria and checking that the first result in the list is title is exactly as stated in the step itself. So this scenario is set to automated, so it can be downloaded to the Test Automation Framework. Furthermore, we can link it to one of the user stories, so we can see the results on the user story itself. So let's do that. So we'll link it to demo 126, which is searching for that in Jira. And once the scenario is linked, we can see it on the user story itself as well. So the preparation is done in the plugin, and now we can move on to how we actually can integrate and download those features into your Test Automation Framework. For that purpose, we developed a range of libraries which are wrappers around the plugin REST API for downloading features and uploading test results. In this video, we'll focus on the Maven integration, which is available on our GitHub, together with some description and installation guidelines. In order to integrate with existing framework, what you need to do is to copy the plugin definition from here and paste it into your POM file in the plugin section. So we'll paste it in here, and let's go through the configuration itself. So the first is project ID. That can be taken from the project configuration page, and that is unique identifier of the project which we are working in inside Jira. Access key and secret key can be taken from the project configuration page as well. In case you are using Jira Data Center, so you need to provide the Jira Data Center URL. And ignore certificate errors, that is again specific to a data center if you're running self-signed certificates. So we'll focus in on the cloud in this demo, so we remove that and we'll go to the Jira project to get access credentials and the project ID. This can be accessed on the project configuration page under apps, access that integration section. So down below we have project ID, copy that, access key, and we'll have to generate a new secret key. So on that, the general configuration is done. Then we move on to the execution part. So we have two executions defined. First is downloading features, and here we specify the output folder where we want to store our features to. So in our case, in this example, we have we want to store it in source, test, resources, com, assert that features. And that is pointing to that directory. Then we can additionally specify the filtering capability, which is the Jira JQL, which filters only scenarios that are linked to a particular issue. So for example, we can specify key equals demo 120, and that is, in fact, 126, that is the issue which we linked our scenario to. Let's refresh it and make sure the scenario appears there. Yeah, we've got the scenario, so we use that demo 126 mode. So that is telling the plugin that we only want to download automated scenarios, which it is. Then additional filtering option is to provide the tag expression. That is a standard Cucumber tag expression, so we can use it to further filter the scenarios. And in our case, we have a scenario which, and we can add some tags to it, for example, demo. So, and we can specify the tag here, goes to demo. Numbered, this is just a convenient option. So when we download the features, the feature name will have an ordinal prepended to the file name. Enabled, whether we enable or disable this execution altogether. So we keep it enabled. Cleanup features, so that is whether we want to delete existing features in the output folder before downloading. And then we have the phase where when this execution will run. So if you're running your test on the integration test phase, then you need to set it to pre-integration test, so the features are downloaded before the test execution. In our example, we run the test on the test phase, so we set it to generate test resources. So this is the basic configuration for downloading features. This is done. Now let's move on to the report execution. And that should execute after the test executed and the Cucumber JSON report file is generated. So this will run on the test phase after the test execution. JSON report folder, we are specifying where the reports are stored. And that location is configured in your Cucumber options themselves. So we have plugin, JSON, and here is the path to the report file. So in this case, we can set it to target report. And the plugin will search for Cucumber JSONs in that subdirectory. JSON report include button. So this is, if you're generating the Cucumber reports per feature, or you have multiple for some reason, then you can specify which ones exactly you want to upload to Jira. Then the report type, by default is Cucumber, but we also support Karate type of reports. We'll keep it to Cucumber for this demonstration. So test run name, this is that just by default, that will be the test run with a timestamp, but we can override it, providing some custom run name. Metadata, any additional information about your test execution, for example, the build number, environment, who executed it, the user, and any other pieces of information in the JSON format. Then the JQL, so this, as opposed to the JQL when we download in features and scenarios, which basically pointing and filtering which scenarios we want to download from the report, from the plugin. This JQL specifies which Jira issues should be updated with the test results after the test execution. So for demonstration purposes, again, we'll specify that JQL equals key to our demo 126, which has our scenario linked to it. Test run ID, so by default, it should set to minus. We can omit it, but optionally, if you have a report already loaded in Jira and you want to add some additional results to that report, you can specify that report ID, and instead of creating new, it will update existing. Enabled, whether the report uploading phase is enabled altogether. So the rest of the framework is pretty basic. So we have step definitions, which are basically Cucumber step definition file with annotated methods which I actually implementing the Gherkin steps. And the run itself, run with cucumber options, specifying where to take the features files, and we can, since we provided the tag demo, so we'll change it here so the cucumber can pick it up, and the where the reports are saved after execution as well. So once this is done, we can run it, and before the test execution, we can see that the scenario and feature will be downloaded to the features folder. It will be picked up by Cucumber Glue, executed, and then the results will be uploaded from the target folder. So we can see that the features goal is executing. Let's have a look whether. Have any features file yet? Yeah, so we have a feature, it takes some time for IDEA to refresh, but that is the feature file that was downloaded. Then the test is being executed. And the report uploaded after the execution. Once that is done, we go back to Jira. Go to the features page. And we can navigate to automation report page, where we can see our custom run name with the statistics of the test which we executed, the metadata, build, environment, and it also, that's this execution added to the charts that we have configured here. So let's go through the charts really quick. So first is scenarios growth trend. So that is signifies how many scenarios we executed in each execution. Then scenario status, success rate, step status, and test execution duration, which is just a useful metric to keep an eye on, especially during UI test automation execution. And the last one is analysis progress, and that tells us how many scenarios were analyzed in each execution. So the scenarios which were failed and whether the resolution for them was set and the root cause was investigated and categorized. Let's go into that test execution, and we'll see that one feature was run. In case you're running multiple features, they all be listed here down below. And this page just has the statistics about that feature and scenarios and steps that were executed. Going into the feature, we have a scenario report, which has the actual steps that we run, the failure reason, stack trace, and the corresponding screenshot, which were taken by Cucumber and embedded into Cucumber JSON results. On this screen, what we can do, we can assign it to someone. In this case, I'll assign it to myself, and then I can set the resolution. So in our case, just the title doesn't match, so probably it is automation defect. So we'll set it refactor the test. Once resolution is set, the command is added here, so it is available for the future reference. And now, after we investigate it, we can navigate back to runs, and we can see that the analysis progress for this execution is fully done, so it's all green. Remember, before the execution, we've linked this scenario to an issue, which was demo 1 to 6. Just use the correct URL. And now, after navigating to the issue and we've run the tests, we can see the status of this scenario was updated on the issue as well. So we can see it failed, and we can open the execution history, and that will contain the information about the test run. So by clicking on that, we can navigate to the test run and see the test results that we've just categorized and investigated as well. So that's briefly about test automation integration using Maven. And the example project is available here on GitHub, which can be cloned and investigated in terms of setup. If you have any additional questions or you'd like assistance and guidelines how we can integrate the plugin with your test automation framework, please contact us at support@assertdat.com or our Slack. All the links will be available in this video description.